your work as distinct, or are they all part of the same artistic statement, if you will?
They're pretty distinct. I mean, the work above Underground is a sideman. For Lou, who's the lead singer, and who wrote most of the material. Doing a solo tour is it's a pretty concentrated situation. You have to you have to draw the audience in to concentrate on just the very simple elements of a song, which are the words and the music, the melody and the rest of it. The songs the presentation does not just provide you with the song as such. The songs sometimes end up in concert as a stream of consciousness, where there are four songs strung together with some piano improvisation between some classical improvisation.
You did a lot of production work between the late 60s and the late 70s, and you seem to have been quieter in the last few years. Are you sick of producing?
No, I'm not sick of it at all. It's because I've been trying to concentrate on several other things. I'm very interested in producing.
You had a reputation in the late 70s for picking up young artists who were later to become seminal figures in new wave music. Were these happy accidents, or were you looking for young people?
It was pretty much because I was looking for people. In order to be able to do something like that, you have to have time in order to do it. You just, if you have several offers of production, there's one way you can do it, is you can accommodate the record companies who flatter you enough to ask you to come in and provide them with your services, or you can go out on your own and look for people on your own.
Your own work has swung between the highly experimental and the almost pop or rock and roll based. Do you naturally just swing between the two?
Well, there's one side of me that really has classical leanings. There's another side that, what I love, rock and roll, that reflects my upbringing. Basically, both of them reflect my upbringing, that I love rock and roll from when I was a kid. And then there's something that is far less clear to me, in that I don't know which side is really going to be represented in a particular song. And some of it is entirely classical, some of it is entirely rock and roll. But then there's a grey area in between that I suppose Paris 1919 represents to the best, which is a half and a half. And I haven't been involved with that kind of songwriting since then, because it's been crazy. It's been more of a swing from experimental to... The music of the Inner Society is more experimental, and Honey Suave before that was heavy metal.
Your new album, as you just mentioned, is called Music for a New Society. It's not only an experimental album, but also one of the most depressing albums I think anyone's ever made. Is it, as the title would imply, a reflection of a changing world situation?
Yeah. I mean, the New Society arrived before I made the record, so it was really just a reflection.
Does that mean, I mean, the world hasn't changed that much since you made that record? If anything, it's gotten worse. Would the new record reflect that?
Well, a lot of people say that record is too depressing. You know, in that case, I'd say that it's not depressing enough. And Kurt Vonnegut, was adamant about, you may think things are bad now, but they're going to get worse. And then after they've gotten worse, they're going to get worse. And when you think things can't get much worse than that, they are going to get worse. So I'm more as if having a good time than I am in demonstrating how bad things can get.